Assalamu alaikum student, today we are going to discuss networking hardware. What are its role to connect different computer between each other, how they are monitored and controlled by using these devices. So let's see what are the networking devices. What is networking hardware? These are devices used to connect computer and other devices with each other. So there are different networking hardware available which make sure that the networking process, so we can communicate with each other using these networking devices. Without these devices, we could not establish any kind of networks. So let's see what they are. Using these devices, our network setup can be established like LAN or internet. So you know that if there is any local area network need to establish, so these devices must be used to set up a LAN or internet. Using LAN or internet, communication can be performed and user can interact with each other. So over a LAN, different persons can talk to each other. They can share data and hardwares. And over internet, we can communicate whatever internet facilities were available. So, but using for that purpose, we need to have networking hardware. Following are the various network devices: cable and wires, NIC, network interface card. This is also called LAN card. Wireless access points, hub or switch, modem, router, bridge, and gateway. There is another device, gateway, which is not written, but there is another device. So these are devices mostly available for networking purpose. Moving to next slide. Here you can see a hub, gateway, router, repeater, bridge, switch. So these are different devices, networking hardware available for the networking purpose. From following link, you can find further detail of these devices. Okay, moving to next slide. What is NIC or LAN card or Ethernet card? It has different name. You must have seen in your computer back. It is available normally back side of the computer. It is a network device which is used to connect computer using cable or wire. The purpose of LAN is to receive data from cable and put data on cable. So remember the network cable where it is attached or which device is used to attach, that is called LAN. It received data from cable and sent to RAM for further processing and received data from CPU and then put data on cable. So as I told you that, basic purpose is to receive data from cable and send to RAM for further processing and receive data from CPU and then put data on cable. Okay. Each computer must have this device to establish LAN. So multiple computer can have network facility for communication and resource sharing. So should remember, normally it comes with the computer system. Here you can see LAN cards. And the left side of the picture. So left side picture, you can see. So these are the LAN cards which are connected on motherboard. From back side of the computer, we can, or laptop, you can find these LAN card. And here you can see right side of the picture, arrow is showing the LAN card. And on box, you can see there is a cable, network cable, which can be attached on LAN cards. Okay, so further detail, you can use the following link. What is hub? It is a kind of network device which is used to connect various computer at a time. So remember, student, when you want to connect two or more than two computer with each other, you need to have a hub. So hub is a device which establish a network of number of computer. It has different ports which are used to connect different computer with each other using LAN card. So multiple computer can be attached using hub. Hub can have a different ports like 8 ports, 16 ports. Hub means central point. When one computer send data to other computer, then this data first move to hub device and hub broadcast this data to every computer connected with hub. This is the function, but also this is the disadvantage. Whenever hub receive data from any computer, it sends to every computer. But only that computer will receive data which has which address matches. So every computer try to match its address with the data. If address is matched, so that computer can pick the data. But disadvantage is that every computer receive data. All irrelevant computer receive the data. Only relevant computer will pick the data. So due to that, it becomes slow. It is slow networking device. It has been replaced by a network switch. So this hub is being replaced by network switch. Here you can see, this is the hub point. Here you can see how hub is being connected with different computers. So if you want to use resource sharing in a better way, you need to have a hub. So multiple computer can connect with each other using hardware resource or software resource. From the following link, you can find further detail of this. Here you can see working of hub. If one PC sending data, these data is received by all computers. So that's why it becomes slow. And there is a collision occurs. Okay, moving to next slide. What is network switch? It is a kind of device which connect various devices with each other using ports in it. The basic function of hub and switch is same, but the only difference is that switch is more intelligent than hub. Hub is not an intelligent device. The function of hub and network switch is same, but the only difference is that when network switch receive data from any computer, then it only send this data to destination computer, but do not broadcast. So hub basically broadcast the data, but switch only unicast the data. It only send to the relevant computer. Both devices make a network. It is an intelligent device, as I told you. Moving to next slide. Here you can see data sent by one node is being received by only destination pieces. Data is forwarded only to the destination. So switch may have having the filter functions. It does not send data to all pieces. So that is why it is faster than switch hub. From the following link, you can find further details. What is network bridge? It is a network device which is used to connect two or more than two nodes. So the difference between switch and bridge is that switch only establish one network, but bridge establish multiple networks. So if you want to connect multiple networks with each other, you need to have a bridge. It creates own networks. A network bridge is a computer networking device that create a single aggregate network from multiple communication network or network access. So I told you, if multiple network need to be connected with each other, so you need to have a bridge. This function is called network bridging. Here you can see how bridge is being connected to different networks or same networks. Data not here also, there is problem of data sending. Data not destined for a device on the other network is prevented from passing over the bridge. So the basic function of bridge is to establish network between multiple networks, but it also filter the data. It send data to destination PC if it receive. From the following link, you can find further detail. Okay, moving to next slide. What is modem? So modem is the device which is used to connect any computer with telecommunication setup for internet purpose. If you want to use internet, you must have a modem. Without modem, you cannot connect with the internet. Modem is the combination of two technologies like modulator and demodulator. So that's why we call it modem. Modulator or modulation means converting digital signal or data into analog signal. And demodulation means converting analog signal to digital data or a signal. Okay, student, whenever we send data from our computer, so modem establish connection with the telecommunication setup. And whenever we send the data, our computer only understand digital data. So whenever we send data over telecommunication lines, it is converted into analog line, means in the voice form or sound form, because our data goes over telecommunication line on the sound form, that is called or voice form, that is called analog form. Okay, on the receiving side, whenever computer receives data, on that side, modem convert analog data into digital form. So computer can understand. So sending modulation means converting digital data into analog, and demodulation means converting analog signal to digital signal. Okay, moving to next slide. It control and monitor the sequence of data over internet. So it has another function. Whatever bits are coming, it count the bits, it control the, it maintains the sequence of bits over internet. Modem. Remember, computer only understand digital signal, and whenever we send our data over internet, then modem converts this digital data signal into analog format, because telephone wire send data in sound format, which is basically analog format, and this process is called modulation. As I told you, on receiving side, computer has modem, which again convert this analog signal into digital form, so that computer can understand, and this process is called demodulation or demodulator. Moving to next slide. Here you can see bits are coming from computer. Modem is converting into analog format and sending over telecommunication setup. And same, if it is receiving from receiving analog signal and converting into digital form. So further detail you can see from the following link. What is router? Router is another networking device. It is a kind of device which is used to connect various networks, and the basic purpose of this device is to identify the best and shortest path among various networks to send data over net. You must have find this device at your home, Wi-Fi router. But that is the function of this router and Wi-Fi router is same. But Wi-Fi router is very limited, has very limited utilization. But the main router has a large utilization, because all over the world, internet is being run by routers. Routers are operated by internet service provider company. Whenever basically we take the connection from ISP and then we use the internet. So whenever we send data or like email or requesting to open web browser, this is the router which decide from which path you can receive the data. So basic purpose is to, the router is to establish a path for sending data or receiving data. All internet service provider companies use this device to establish internet setup, as I told you. Small kind of router is also being used at home to use as a Wi-Fi device for internet connecting by different users. So every user receive its own data from different path. Here you can see the function of router, main router. So router A, router B, router C, see, these are establishing their own networks and finding the path. Here and the right side picture, you can see 192.168.0. So this is the address of PC, and this address is identified by the router. We try to find best path or shortest path. What is WAP? It is a device which is used to connect various computers with each other without the cables or wire using wireless network card. So if you want to set a wireless LAN, so you need to have a WAP device. WAP also available on laptop. It is built in laptop. Using this device, wireless LAN can be established, and even internet can be accessed for internet resources. So for wireless LAN, you need to have WAP. It allowed unwired network to connect with wired networks. Here you can see students, two pictures, how WAP is being used. So there is a wired networks used for that purpose. You need to have a switch. So switch connect different computer, and also it connects with the router. Same here, right side, you can see wireless access point, which is being established for wireless LAN. For further detail, you can see, use the following link. So this is the end of lecture. Thank you. Have a nice day. Hope you understand these lectures.